At makausap natin ngayon, walang iba, si Madam Jennifer Castro. Good morning, Jennifer!
Good morning! Kumusta?
Okay lang, okay lang. So, nakaka-proud naman. So, unang-una, gusto ko lang malaman, taga saan ka sa atin?
Ah, sa Pampanga.
Pero una kong katanungan sa iyo, pwede mo bang ikwento sa amin? Can you tell us a little about your background at paano ka nagsimula in the entertainment industry?
Well,
Okay.
actually, so my background, so yeah, my parents, taga Pampanga, at doon ako pinanak. Pero lumaki ako sa Pilipinas, sa Papua New Guinea, and Australia. Tapos, I moved to the UAE in 2006 to follow my Portuguese fiance, who afterwards naging pumasawa. And sa ngayon, nagtatrabaho ako full-time sa isang government entity sa Abu Dhabi. And I do acting on a kind of like a part-time, casual basis. And how did I start sa film industry dito sa UAE? Well, actually, nung pumanaw ang asawa ko in 2016, pinayuhan ako ng isang kapwa byuda na kailangan kong libangin ang sarili ko para maiwasan ang sobrang kalungkutan. So, naghanap ako ng mga activities to keep my mind off my grief. And so, I tried doing voluntary work. I attended art workshops, and when I was Googling on the internet, I came across two casting websites. So, nag-register ako, and I applied for a role as an extra in a Nigerian film, which was it was being shot in the Atlantis Hotel. So, yun ang nagsimula. I started off as an extra. And then, during COVID, because I had more time on my hands, I started applying for more roles. So between 2021 and 2023, I appeared in several commercials. I was an extra on Mission Impossible. I had speaking roles in two Indian films. I had a brief appearance in a K-pop music video.
Madam, may isa akong question. What is the title of yung bagong movie mo, tsaka what is it all about?
The title of the movie is Al Aid Aden, which means twice the trouble. But the working title in English is Holiday Gone Wrong. So it's about a Saudi Emirati family sa Abu Dhabi na may nangyaring hindi inaasahan when they woke up on the second day of Eid at na-discover nila na nawawala yung isa nilang nani. So determinado sila na hindi magiging hadlang ito sa kanilang kasiyahan. Nagpatuloy pa rin ang pamilya sa kanilang bakasyon at marami nakakatuwang pangyayari ang naganap sa bakasyon nila.
Wow!
So dahil naranasan ng pamilya ang sitwasyon na hindi nila nakasanayan, marami silang natutunan tungkol sa sarili nila at lalo silang naging close as a family. So actually, sa mga hindi pa nakakapanood ng Arabic movies, lalo na tungkol sa buhay ng mga lokal, marirealize nila na essentially, kagaya din natin ang mga lokal na may mga issues sa mga in-laws, may parenting challenges, at hindi magkakaintindihan minsan ng mag-asawa. So, overall though, ang message is, family is very important, and love and bonding in the family is important.
Can you share any memorable or kaya funny moments from that set? Yung nagsushoot kayo, habang nagsushoot kayo, mayroon bang mga memorable moments na na-encounter mo?
Well, actually, yung film, it was shot like 12 months ago. So July last year, inupisahan i-shoot ang film. And actually, while we were shooting the film, my 50th birthday happened. And coincidentally, dito sa film, my character's birthday is celebrated at the end of the film. And so throughout the film, parang linagay sa story ang birthday ng character ko. Pero during the shoot, I was very quiet kasi I'm very low key when it comes to my birthday, so I didn't make a big, you know, hoo ha about it. Pero it was just really for me very memorable na my character's birthday and my real birthday like coincided with the film.
May nag-inspire ba sa'yo to become an artist, or meron ka ba mga malaking mga nag-influence sa'yo?
Yeah, well, yun nga, like, the reason why this whole acting started in the first place is because my husband passed away, you know. And I actually started in this industry quite late. Like I was 48 years old when I started. And dahil sa trahedya ng pagpanaw ng asawa ko, yun ang dahilan kung bakit napasukan ko maging artista. Kapag may dramatic scenes, yung emotions at luha, you know, agad lumalabas agad kapag naiisip ko siya. So my late husband is my inspiration. And, you know, actually another big inspiration of mine is Ricky Martin, who I've actually met like 8 times nung nakatira ako sa London.
Ricky Martin, the former member ng Menudo?
Yeah, exactly. So I grew up in that era when Menudo was really big and I was a big Menudo fan. Pero like, you know, the Ricky Martin thing is a long and interesting story. But the circumstances which led to my first meeting with him made me realize that if you put your creativity, like if you put creativity, determination, and luck together, you can achieve quite a lot of things.
Meron ka bang encounter na mga challenges while working on this particular movie at paano mo ito na-overcome?
During the filming of the movie, may mga dialogue ako in Arabic. I don't really speak Arabic fluently. So I had to actually learn my lines. And I would have to, I mean, I asked my fellow castmates to how to pronounce certain phrases. And so, you know, I just had to memorize my dialogue and deliver it in the most, I guess, natural way.
What are your long-term goals as an artist in the entertainment industry? At meron ka bang upcoming na project or plans?
Right now my plan is to have to work on one feature film at least a year. And I want to continue pursuing roles na very different and challenging. I also want to continue going to acting workshops to develop my acting abilities and to stretch my skills. I also want to support other aspiring talents, be the go-between in them collaborating with, say, photographers or student filmmakers so they can develop their portfolio. And I just want to be involved in as many projects as I can. Actually, I'm very excited. On the 10th and 11th of August, Jet Tolentino, you know, he's a very famous Filipino, like Grammy Award winning and Tony Award winning, like director producer. He's holding a filmmaking workshop specifically for Filipino creatives. So I'm joining that, and I'm really looking forward to that.
Bilang sang artista, ano yung dream role mo?
Okay, I've already tried drama. Right, and I'm pretty good at drama. Comedy is more challenging because I think you need good timing and really not everybody can be funny, you know. So I would like to try more comedic roles. I guess action because I'm not the most athletic person. No? That would be a challenge.
All right.
But I don't know if I can take time off work to do that. Pero that would be very, very interesting for me.
Any mensahe para sa mga listeners na gustong marating na ang yung narating mo ngayon sa movie industry dito pa sa UAE, ano yung mga mensahe mo para sa kanila?
Ang message ko sa kanila, it's never too late to start. If you really want to try this industry, start off as an extra, right? Para you get the experience of being on set. Pero if you really want to develop your skills, attend acting workshops, collaborate and network with people in the industry, develop patience because there's a lot of waiting around on set, and also be realistic because this is not a job that you can do full-time. I still have my full-time job. I'm keeping it. Pero it allows me to enjoy acting. Because you don't have that starving artist mentality. You know, na at the end of the day, meron ka pa rin ano, a full-time job na to fall back on. Pero like, just if you really want to start it, volunteer for any acting role that you can get into, participate in acting workshops, and network. That's the main advice that I can give.
Ayan, yan pating kabayan. Proud of proud tayo. Isa siyang artista ngayon dito sa UAE.
Si Jennifer Castro. At isa lang ang masasabi namin sa iyo.
Iba ka, kabayan.
Thank you po. Salamat.
Tag 91.1.
Pinoy talaga.